Let's do now part C of this exercise on normal logic program with variables. So here I have written the program P and I just write the initial of the atoms to make things simpler. So first we have to compute the ground instantiation of the program, and I've already written it here. And for this first, I have written the Hebbrand universe, which contains the constants 0, 1, and 2 that occur in the program. And then for the first rules, they are facts, so they just belong to the ground instantiation. And for this unique rule with variables, it has two variables, x and y, and we have to replace them by the combinations of the elements of this set. So first we replace x, y by 0, 0, then by 0, 1, by 0, 2, and so on, and we get these 9 combinations, these 9 ground instantiations of the rule. Good, so this is the ground program. Now, let's find the stable models of this program. Now, something that is clear just looking at it is that if there is going to be a stable model, then it must have the facts n 0, 1, n 1, 2, and n 2, 0. Because the facts belong to every stable model of the program. And now, looking at this rule, we can also draw some consequences that here we have n01, here n12, and n20. So these atoms are true, and then these rules can fire, but for the other atoms of predicate n, there is no way to derive them. So then these rules can never be applicable. The ones that I'm deleting. So we can just not consider them anymore because we know they are not never going to be applicable because some atoms in the positive body cannot be derived. So then we are left with these three rules. And about these three rules, we no longer have to think about because we know they have this, they give us these three atoms that will belong to every stable model of the program. So now we have S0 if not S1, S1 if not S2, and S2 if not S0. So I don't see how to derive anything from here directly. So let's reason by cases. I start with not S1, for example, on one side, and let's look for models with S1 on the other side. So if I do not have S1, I must have S0. And for example, If I do not have S1, it must be the case that I have S2, because otherwise I would get the S1. So S2 must hold. And what else? And then for S2 also, this is the unique rule, but this rule disappears from the redact because we have S0, so there's no way to derive S2, so we can derive not S2. Okay, good, we see here, we have a contradiction. So if we look for stable models without S1, we conclude that they must have S2 because using this rule. And on the other hand, it must not have S2 using this other rule. Or I think it was the other way around. It must not have S2 using this rule because S1 is false. So it must have S2 to falsify this. And since given that this is false, there is no way to derive S2, so S2 should be false. Right, so we lead to a contradiction, so then we can say that there is no stable model that doesn't have S1. And also something that we could have done is, once we arrive at this point and we have these three atoms, we could have tried to done the redact, and we would see that the consequences of the redact do not coincide with this stable model with this interpretation with S0, S2. So let's do this quickly. So just taking into account S0 and S2, we do the redact. So here this disappears, and here I have S2 and S0, so this disappears, then I only get S0, and I do not get S2, hence this is not a stable model, which is the same conclusion that we arrived before, just looking at the fact that we were not going to be able to get S2, which is exactly what we have seen in the redact, that we just got S2, but there was no way to achieve this S2. So then no stable model on this side. Good. Now let me clean this redirect that I've just done. Good. So let's go to the other side. So we have S1. Given that we have S1, this will disappear from the redirect, hence there's no way to derive S0. So S0 cannot be in the stable model. And if S0 is not in the stable model, with this rule we derive S2. Right, but on the other hand, for S1 to be in a stable model, it must be the case that S2 is false. And then again, we reach a contradiction. So then it cannot be the case that there's a stable model with S1. And let's repeat the reasoning, because if there is S1, then the other way to prove S1 is if S2 is false. So S2 must be false on the one hand. And in, on the other hand, from having S1, we derive that S2 has to be false, and if S2 has to be false, S2, sorry, having S1, we derive that S0 must be false because there's no way to derive it, and if S0 is false, we derive S2. So again, we reach a contradiction, so we know that this program has no stable models. So let's write it here, stable models, none. And just, I will do as before. If you had arrived here and you see, okay, all atoms are assigned, so let's do the redirect, you would see that this, that the consequences of the redirect are not S1, S2 for this case. So let's do it here. This is, this goes away from the redirect, and also this goes away, and this literal goes away. So then we have the consequence S2, but there is no way to derive this S1 in this case. So you see, we would also in this way conclude that this is not a stable model. And finally, we have this result that this program has no stable model. Good. So let's move on to the next one.